What's up, B2? Capital G here. We got more Guard Dragon variant action for you guys to check out. As I've said before, I feel like Guard Dragons, the archetype, are doing the same thing to the Dragon type that he sold, basically did the Warriors, just taking the entire type to a whole different level. It's making it so much better. We've seen this small kind of archetype be used with like Buster Blader because there's a bunch of dragons in there. Now you guys are going to see how Radix take their turn to basically show you some of the ridiculous plays that they can do. Now, these are off the back of Crystron Needle Fiber, I won't lie, but I will show some other duels where Needle Fiber is not even used, and I think it really all comes back to the fact that now you can summon Red Eyes Metal Darkness Dragon from your deck. Now, for Heretics as an archetype, they're like, yo, that's not even something new. We've been doing that since the Zexal days. So, for them, yeah, they've been doing that forever, but for most archetypes, they didn't have that ability. And then, it's like, not just getting Red Eyes on field and using the effect once, but then being able to get it back from the graveyard. It's just like so many monster reborns, and you can take those monsters and turn them into some really good things. And when you get to summon things like Hot Red Dragon Archery and Abyss for free, then it becomes kind of nutty. So you can see right here, he's setting up the little dragons. Those are going to eventually be turned into the Guard Dragon Link monsters. And, you know, with a card like Destrudo that summons itself back from the graveyard, it's a really good resource. So Red Eyes is used once, and now you go into Sarge Skulldread, who just happens to be another dragon monster. Bring Red Eyes back again. Red Eyes goes back to the graveyard, and now you can replace that with your Hot Red Dragon Archfiend Abyss. And I think that this is actually a pretty cool play. So this is kind of cheeky. So he's going to summon the Primordial Chaos Dragon. This is the one that just came out of Soul Fusion, and he actually takes a card out of his opponent's hand. So if it wasn't bad enough trying to deal with these really strong turn one boards with a full hand, now you got to do it with less than a full hand. So he has to put that Oracle of Zephra back in. You see right here, he wasn't done. He actually goes into another powerful dragon monster, the number 38 Titanic Galaxy. And don't forget that this the Heretic Link monster actually has some built-in disruption as well. It's basically like a compulse evac device. It's not like the greatest. It's nowhere near as strong as these two guys, but it's not bad at all. And he said Monster Reborn this entire time. So he could have just like reborned his Skulldread for some more damage or something like that. There really wouldn't have been a point of summoning Red Eyes back because he doesn't have any more monster zones left. So it's no real point of doing that. But I guess he wants to leave a little bit of something for next turn. His opponent starts with Pot of Indulgence. That's just going to get absorbed. Then he goes for Preparation of Rites. I probably would not have negated that. Now, if it was pre-prep, I would have negated it. But he's going to use that on Juan for Juan with my cousin Juan. He gets the Oracle Zephyr off. The problem is he's only going to be able to Pendulum Summon one here. Now, that monster is a monster that searches. But overall, it's like, what are you going to do? The one downside to the Guard Dragons in their play, the monster that you actually get, like whatever that Synchro is, whether it's Crystal Wing or Hot Red Dragon Archery and Abyss, that monster is not considered to be properly summoned. So he cannot use Monster Reborn on this Hot Red Dragon Archery and Abyss. It's not a legal target. It's basically the same as if you summoned a Stardust Dragon from Starlight Road. If that Stardust Dragon tributes itself, or if your opponent attacks over it, it's basically dead forever. You're not going to be able to get it back from the graveyard. You have to, you know, summon it properly. That's why when he summons Red Eyes back, he doesn't actually go for the Hot Red Dragon Archery and Abyss. And obviously he easily kills his opponent, but it's just something to know if you are summoning a really big powerful dragon. If that thing dies, you can't get it back from the graveyard by conventional means. Can't Monster Reborn it, can't Red Eyes it back or something like that. But you see that dragons now have the power to really, really take over the game. You know what these new dragon builds kind of remind me of? They kind of remind me of Heretic Rulers. You guys remember the deck that was only legal for like, you know, one weekend, the Heretic Rulers with Dark Matter Dragon? It kind of reminds me of that. But I'll pause for one quick second and show you guys what the deck looks like. Okay, so this is what the deck looks like on paper, and this is definitely a hybrid deck. There are not nearly as many Heretic as I thought we would have saw, although I guess there are a lot of ways of being able to activate them. Well, mainly we saw a Downbeat being used. Then, you know, he runs a small rocket engine in there, not just because one of the rocket monsters is a tuner, the Rocket Synchron that comes out of Savage Strike that can be summoned off a Needle Fiber, but I guess rockets also give you dragon monsters that you can summon straight from the deck. If you activate Quick Resolve, you can get a rocket monster on board so that can instantly turn into a Link monster. So I don't know, maybe these will, you know, definitely help Rockets out as an archetype as well. A lot of people are running this right here, the world, or the guard dragon of the world legacy. This is the one that basically lets you move your monsters around, so it becomes a little bit easier to actually, you know, get those zones where a bunch of link monsters are actually pointing to them. It looks like the card is actually pretty good. I didn't really think that it was that good, but you know, overall a lot of people are using it, so must be a reason. There are no traps in this deck because Heretics didn't generally, like, historically mesh that well with traps, but a lot of these dragon decks are all about the early game. You know, get a couple of negations on board and basically just overpower your opponent. You play things like Monster Reborn to get those monsters back if they happen to die, but overall, yeah, definitely looking like dragons are moving forward as a type, and it'll be interesting to see how much the guard dragons actually affect the meta, especially if we don't have Needle Fiber. You know, if we don't have Needle Fiber, I wonder if they'll just flame out. I guess only time will tell.